discussing about the classification of accounts. So classification of accounts, we can classify basically under the two method. One is the traditional method and the next one is the modern method. But today I am discussing classification of accounts under traditional method. Traditional method. So under traditional method, at first I can classify into the two heads. First one is the impersonal account and the personal account. Okay, so impersonal account, again we can classify into the two heads. First one is the real account and the next one is the nominal account. Okay, so first I am discussing about the real account. So what is the meaning of real account? So the real account is relating to the assets. What? The real account is relating to the assets. So assets we can classify into the again two heads. One is the tangible assets and the intangible assets. So tangible and the intangible both. So under tangible means which we can see and we can touch the assets. That means land and building, plant and machinery. Similarly, furniture will be there. Similarly, say for example in a school, say for example school building is there, computer lab is also there, the buses for the transportation of the children, so etc. So the tangible fixed assets example is the land and building, plant and machinery and etc. Now intangible, most important part is the intangible fixed asset. Intangible means we cannot touch the assets, but we can feel the asset. Say for example the goodwill of the business, say for example trademark, say for example copyright, and say for example patent right. So goodwill, trademark, copyright and the patent right, these are the more important intangible fixed assets. So the tangible and intangible both comes under the head real account. Clear on this part? Now I am going to the part of nominal account. So nominal account includes, there are two parts. One is the expenses and losses, first one, and the second one is the incomes and gains. So expenses and losses means the all type of expenses and the losses relating to the business. Say for example salary paid, rent paid, electricity bill paid, or any type of expenses for a school. Say for example the expenses for the fuel of the car, cleaning expenditure, for the purchase expenditure of marker, paint, dusters, etc. So all type of expenses and the losses relating to the business, maybe the abnormal and the normal loss, both type of losses comes under the head nominal account. This part is clear. Next is the incomes and gains. Incomes and gains means the incomes and gains relating to the business. Say for example sales, say for example commission received, say for example interest received, say for example rent received, say for example dividend received, etc. So all types of incomes and gains relating to the business comes under the head nominal account. So the nominal account is clear. Okay, so I have given the example. So now more important part is the personal account. Now we can classify personal account into the three heads. First is the natural personal account. What is the meaning of natural personal account? Now natural personal account means is relating to the human beings. So human beings means who are the relating to the business organization human beings. Say for example the Ram account, Syam account, etc, etc. So I can classify here. So natural personal account. Okay, so natural personal account means human being. So who are the example of natural person? Say for example Ram account. Second one is say for example Syam account. Say for example Hori account. Okay, so the persons relating to the business comes under the head of natural personal account. Okay, next part is the artificial. So what is the meaning of artificial personal account? The artificial personal account means man-made person. Artificial. So artificial personal account means man-made person means, say for example, any type of school, any type of college, any type of university, any type of business organization. It may be the sole proprietorship, it may be the partnership business, it may be the cooperative business. All type of business comes under the head the artificial personal account. Clear on this part? So any type of school, any type of college, university, okay, any type of corporate sector, the example is, say for example, any types of banks, okay. Next part is the representative personal account. So representative personal account, I can classify. See here, representative personal account means I have written here the before and after of nominal account. Before and after of nominal account, if you see the accrued, prepaid, pre-received and the outstanding. Okay, so if you see accrued, pre-received, prepaid and outstanding is there before and after of nominal account. Say for example, salary paid. So salary paid is a nominal account, we know. It's a nominal account because the expenses. But if you see the outstanding salary means outstanding before the nominal account salary. So this is called representative personal account. Similarly, say for example, accrued income. Say for example, I have given accrued rent. So say for example, rent paid is nominal account, we know. But accrued rent is a representative personal account. So clear in this part? Similarly, the prepaid insurance. Insurance is a nominal account, but when prepaid before the insurance, so this is called representative personal account. So I have given, see, the outstanding salary, accrued rent, prepaid insurance and pre-received rent. So these are the examples of the nominal account, real account and the personal account, and these are the entire concept of classification of accounts under traditional method. Clear on this part? Okay, bye.